Hey kids, thanks for checking in. This is our fourth video. So we've done this four Sunday school lessons. This is lesson number four. And this week we're talking about the church and what all the things that happen inside the church. It's more than just coming to church and worshiping and learning about Jesus. The church does a lot of things to impact and change a community, okay? And they do a lot of things to help families and people throughout the community that are going through tough things. So the early church in Acts chapter 11 is the story this morning that you're going to hear about how the Antioch church helped, okay? And I want you to listen to the story that you're going to see on the video here in a few minutes. And then I want you to think about, we'll kind of put the pause button up on the screen, and you think about ways that our church tries to reach out and help people. What are some things that we can do here in our town, in our community, that can help other people? It can help kids, it can help older people, that can help families. So it's a really, really good question because the church does a lot of things, and the first churches that ever got started, they took care of people. They reached out and they tried to love people and help people that were in need. So that's the first thing we want you to check into. All right. So I'm going to pray. And there's going to be a music video coming up here in just a minute. There's also going to be a video of the little girl that's at summer camp. You're going to see her and her friends again. And then also from week one, we had a missionary. And she went to Mozambique, which is in Africa. And so it's a second part to that this week where she is showing us these kids that are building houses out of mud and how they do that. So we want to watch the missionary video, but thank you for taking the time to watch us and for slowing down. We hope you're reading your Bible and you're praying and you're talking to God about all this stuff that's happening in our world right now. And we can't wait to see you again in person. All right, let's pray. God, thank you for helping us. Thank you for teaching us. And thank you for all these teachers that help us to learn about your son, Jesus, through Sunday school. It's in his name we pray, amen. All right, enjoy these next couple videos, all right?
Jesus' followers who lived in Jerusalem were persecuted and treated badly. Many of them left their homes and moved to different countries and cities. Wherever they went, these believers told the people how Jesus died on the cross and rose again. Some of Jesus' followers moved to the city of Antioch. And just like in other places, these believers began to tell the people all that Jesus had done. Soon, a church began in Antioch. God helped the church grow. And many people believed that Jesus is the Son of God. If this was happening today, it would be number one trending forever. The church in Jerusalem heard about the new believers in Antioch and decided to send Barnabas to teach people more about Jesus and encourage the new believers. Barnabas was a good man who was filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. When Barnabas arrived in Antioch, he was glad to see and meet the new believers. He encouraged them to remain true to Jesus. Barnabas saw so many people believe in Jesus that he went to Tarsus to get Saul and bring him to Antioch to help. For a year, Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught many people. Antioch is where believers in Jesus were called Christians for the first time. One day, some prophets came from Jerusalem to the Antioch church. One prophet was named Agabus. Agabus told the Antioch church that a severe famine would come to the Roman world. This included Judea, the country where Jerusalem was located. There would be no rain, and the people would have a hard time finding food to eat. They didn't have a local Walmart to hop down and grab an energy drink. The members of the church in Antioch wanted to help those who would be in need during the famine. Each person gave what he was able to give. When the church members collected everything, Barnabas and Saul took the gifts to the believers in Judea.
Something weird is going on. Like, weirder than talking squirrels or flying snakes. My imagination gets the best of me on nature hikes, but my news is weirder than any of that. Paris wants to help others.
Good morning, campers! Welcome to another beautiful day at Camp Chicken Lake! And remember, campers, the volleyball courts are for volleyball only. Please.
Paris wanting to help is way out of character.
I once told Paris our teacher was in the hospital. She just rolled her eyes and said, "Nobody looks good in hospital scrubs."
When I was raising money for the Little League jerseys, Paris asked me what color. When I told her they would be red, she closed her eyes and pretended to fall asleep.
I admit that it's hard for me to care about things, people, but all that is about to change. I've been made aware of a terrible struggle Christians are facing in the world today. And even though I'm not known for my helpful ways, I'm doing my part to make a difference. The biggest issue Christians are up against is a major lack of fashion.
What now?
I've been up all night designing for the fashion-forward Christian. Please enjoy. Lannis is wearing something from our new summer line. This playful yet elegant piece screams, "Don't look at me," while still whispering, "Take a peek." It's perfect for a night on the town or a morning in Sunday school. You're welcome, Christians, and the world.
Hysterical design aside, you can't really think you can help people by being a designer.
Don't listen to Stephanie. Wanting to help other Christians is actually one of the major jobs of the church. In many ways, we're all on this journey together, so we should support each other.
Maybe Stephanie is right. I can't use my designer skills to help Christians.
I wouldn't say that. The boldness of your new design might have thrown me off at first.
That's because you have terrible fashion sense, silly.
Okay, but there are lots of ways you can use your designing talents to help. Like you demonstrated, clothing that Christians can wear.
But you can also sell the clothes you designed to raise money for missions. Or you can design and donate clothes to those in need. The possibilities are endless. The church can always be on the lookout for those to help our fellow Christians. Great job, Paris.
Can I change back into my regular clothes now? Hello? Paris? Can you hear me?
Hey!
We just started redoing the whole church. They put sticks on the side of the walls to make the actual, I guess, the walls from, I think from coconut trees. So after they made the sticks, they put mounds of dirt inside, like the, inside and outside the church. And then they'll go get water from the well and bring it and pour it into the dirt and mix it, stomp all over it with their feet and make it in a mud. So then you have these big, huge things of mud that you are gonna put on the walls. Then you pick up some of the mud and you basically just throw it at the wall. So first, I'm assuming that first you actually kind of just nicely put it there, but then to make the actual wall, you're just throwing the mud onto the wall, which is a lot of fun.
Lord, I am so amazed. Been
Well, I hope you really enjoyed those videos. If you can think back to the little girl that was at church camp and wanted to be a fashion designer, some of her friends said that's probably not a good idea. But you know what? There's a lot of different ways that God can use us and use our talents to make a difference for somebody else. And so in the end, her friend encouraged her to maybe she could design clothes and do it in a way that was going to help other people out. So think about that, the ways that you can help somebody out around the house. Maybe you can help somebody out that lives close to you that can't do some things for themselves. And that's what the church has been doing for years, is trying to be in a community and in a town and in a city. And the church tries to do things to help people and love people in the hopes that they see Jesus in us. All right. So hope you enjoyed the videos. Can be praying for the kids and the missionary in Mozambique, and hope to see you again next week. All right, have a great rest of the week.